Discrete versus continuous distribution of charges. In this video, we are going to discuss difference between discrete and continuous distribution of charges. All the possible charges in the universe are in the form of n into e, where n is an integer. It may be minus 2, minus 1, 0, or 1, 2, 3, etc. And e is the elementary charge whose value is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. We know the charge on one electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. When charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb, the number of electron is equal to 1. When the charge is 1 coulomb, the number of electron will be equal to 1 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19, which is equal to 10 to the power of 19 divided by 1.6, which is equal to 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. We are now clear that E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb, and thus there are about 6 into 10 to the power of 18 number of electrons in a charge of minus 1 coulomb. In electrostatics, charges of this magnitude are seldom encountered, and hence we use smaller charges, 1 microcoulomb, which is equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 coulomb, or 1 millicoulomb, which is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 coulomb. All the possible charges in the universe are in the form of n into e, where n is an integer. It may be minus 2, minus 1, 0, or 1, 2, 3, etc. And e is the elementary charge whose value is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. If the protons and electrons are the only basic charges in the universe, all the observable charges have to be integral multiples of E. Thus, if a body contains n1 electrons and n2 protons, the total amount of charge on the body is n2 into E plus n1 into minus E, which is equal to n2 minus n1 into E. Since n1 and n2 are integers, their difference is also an integer. Thus, the charge on any body is always an integral multiple of E and can be increased or decreased also in steps of E. We know that the electronic charge E equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb, and we have already discussed that charge on any body is always an integral multiple of E and can be increased or decreased also in steps of E. The step size of E, however, very small, because at macroscopic level we deal with the charges of few microcoulomb. At this scale, the fact that the charge of a body can increase or decrease in units of E is not visible. Therefore, the grainy nature of charge is lost and it appears to be continuous. The picture shows the linear charge distribution, the area charge distribution, and the volume charge distribution. In all these distributions, the variation of charges in steps of E is found to be very small. In linear charge distribution, even though charges are the point charges in a linear dimension, at a distance it appears to be a straight line. And in the area charge distribution also, if the point charges are distributed in the area, it seems it is like the area painted with the charges. It is continuous. And also in volume charge distribution also, let you assume a volume. The volume is not appear to be of discrete charges. It is completely filled with charges, just like air molecules. It is also be continuous.